Buongiorno a tutti, sono Lucio Buratto, sono un chirurgo oculista. Desidero innanzitutto ringraziarvi per essere qui oggi. Desidero ringraziare il Mido, l'organizzazione del Mido, in particolare il dottor Gili per averci ospitato, per aver ospitato i nostri quadri, le nostre opere d'arte. Come chirurgo oculista appassionato d'arte, ho pensato di realizzare un progetto che si chiama LOVE4VISION, che si propone di stimolare i giovani alla produzione di opere d'arte legate ai problemi della vista. A tale scopo ho contattato l'Accademia di Brera ed altre accademie italiane e ho ottenuto la realizzazione di opere da parte degli studenti, opere riferite ai problemi appunto della vista. Con queste opere abbiamo realizzato una mostra.
These works, so we organized an exhibition at an international congress that I organize every year, and today these works will be displayed at Mido as well. On the 18th of May, there will be an auction at Sotheby's at the Four Seasons Hotel in Milan. The idea is that of selling these works that were donated by the artists, and with the revenues, and we would like to sponsor a charity project with the revenues. So please visit Optic Club and see these works of art, and I also invite you to join us for dinner at the Four Seasons Hotel, and you may also buy some of these works to sponsor this very interesting and beautiful project. Good afternoon, my name is Julian Buratto. I was in charge of the implementation of the LOVE4VISION project. So the project has existed for 2 years in Milan. It started with an exhibition. So LOVE stands for luce, light, occhio, eye, and visione, vision. That's the name of the exhibition that has been organized with different academies. This year with the Accademia di Brera in Milan and Liège. And thanks to the works of art, we've had great success in the field of visual communication. Many Italian artists, besides the students of the Accademia, donated to Buratto very important works of art to raise funds. And this is the first time we have managed to combine the world of visual arts, the world of care, and the world of vision. Arts in general, and especially visual arts, are extremely important to highlight the world of vision, the importance of vision, the importance of seeing properly and living well thanks to vision. Just imagine what could happen if we were not able to move or to run, to hug, or to spend a normal life. And what if we weren't able to read a newspaper, to watch TV, to play chess with friends, or to see our grandchildren grow up, for example? For this reason, we have decided to focus on elderly people living in elderly homes. And thanks to the help of Dr. Joe, who is present here today, and thanks to the Istituto Sacra Famiglia from Giuseppe Buscone, we decided to raise funds and to donate those funds so that checkups that can be performed in elderly houses. We will try and bring young people to elderly homes so that they can present their works themselves, thus creating a connection and a link between younger and older generations in elderly homes, so that we could also generate an exchange of information and culture. LOVE4VISION is therefore aimed at increasing the importance of vision, especially among elderly people, stimulating young people from this perspective and filling the gap between older and younger generation. Now I would like to give the floor to Dr. Joe from Istituto di Sacra Famiglia, Cesano Boscone, who will explain what we're going to do with these works. Thank you. Good afternoon. I'm an eye physician. Well, I'm not as important as Dr. Buratto, of course, and I'm really honored for presenting this initiative on behalf of Buratto. He's one of the most famous eye surgeons in Italy for great scientific merits. So this initiative is extremely stimulating for all physicians like me. I'm an eye doctor and a surgeon. Well, you know, I work for this foundation, Sacra Famiglia. There is a hospital. I have a practice that was established recently. Well, maybe I'm there because I couldn't find anything else, but I've really discovered a new world. I have discovered the world of disability, and I'm really grateful to have this experience and to have the enthusiasm to pursue certain initiatives and to be supported by Lucio Buratto performing a screening activity. And this is actually the very objective of this initiative, and I couldn't pursue this objective on my own. One day I had the chance of operating a disabled person, and well, he had even the anesthesiologist, and on the next day he came to me and thanked me because he could finally see the sun, and this gave me the motivation, and from then I have really operated many people, and I could really appreciate my role in ophthalmology. There is also an optometric issue that we would like to develop in the future. In any case, my institution, Sacra Famiglia, is based in northern Italy. It has 16 centers. The headquarters are in Cesano Boscone, but, well, it's basically Milan, and deals with all types of disabilities. As a matter of fact, there are not only elderly people, but also disabled who have become old, and elderly people who have become disabled with age. So the idea is that of taking care of people who need a family. The institute was established a century ago based on the initiative, an initiative of a priest who wanted to host the met people from the countryside. And now disabled are different. So these are people who cannot perform certain activities, and visual impairment, visual disability, accounts for 80% of all disabilities. Eye diseases must be treated in order to treat disabled who become older, or elderly people who become disabled, and this has to be performed in order to avoid the development of other diseases that lead to visual impairment as well. These are some facts and figures related to Fondazione Sacra Famiglia concerning disabilities, but we also take care of outpatients, so people suffering from maculopathy are disabled because they lose vision with time. So these numbers are actually limited. The idea is that of performing screening activities within elderly homes. Screening would be performed by an optometrist and optician and an eye doctor, with specific devices provided within the framework of this project in specific rooms. And then we could also draw some conclusions about prognosis, prevention, and therapies and treatments to be established to improve vision among the disabled who are hospitalized in our centers. This is basically in a few words the idea and the aim of the project that Julien Buratto presented to you earlier. Thank you. So please visit LOVE4VISION Facebook page on Facebook. It is free of charge, so please do it, especially if you use social networks. Please click on our page. The more clicks we have, the more shares we have, the higher the number of elderly people who we can screen in elderly homes. So, LOVE4VISION. You will find the Facebook page.